Welcome to Enjoying Life, a program of music, chatter, and friends designed to put a refreshing moment in your day. Now, please welcome your award-winning hosts, Dr. Jerry and Little Jan.
Oh, thank you, Paul. Thank you so much. Well, sweetheart, it's time to do some more programs of Enjoying Life.
I'm telling you, we come out here and we've had a great time in Florida.
Oh, we have. Yeah, we've had some time off. And so, you know, you've been watching all the programs and a few reruns now and then. But now it's time to do some brand new, fresh programs, and we're excited about
it. It'll be fun.
You know, we've had a lot of feedback from different places.
From this show.
You know, a guy that you went to Europe with when you and Wendy were in Europe, they called him Billy Bob.
Billy Bob.
He played steel guitar?
He did.
Yeah. Well, we got an email from him. His true name is Bob Everett. Did you know that?
Bob Everett.
Yeah.
Did you tell him where we know him from?
Well, yeah,
okay,
do I tell?
No, you tell them.
Well, they, you know, they did a series of programs overseas for the military.
Yes.
Back in 1960 something. Can you believe that? And Little Jan and them were singing. They spent 3 months traveling through North Africa and Spain and Europe and Germany and all that area over there. And they were singing the gospel in the programs over there. That's great, isn't it?
And that's where we met Billy Bob.
Yep, because he's part of the program. And David Reese was there, and, you know, of course, Wendy and Geraldine and all that bunch.
That's right.
Well, it's time for us to do some singing.
All right, let us do some singing.
You know, to all of us, at some point in our lives, once in a while, we reach a spot where we need a touch. You ready to get a mic?
Yes, let's get a mic.
And so I was at that point. I needed a touch. And just when we need a touch, God will send his presence. And so that's when this song came to my mind. And I sat down to begin to write it. It just simply says, sufficient for me.
Sufficient for me. Sufficient for me. His grace is sufficient and free. Sufficient for me. I'm not worthy, he cried, to stand by your side. I'm a leper and I'm blind, as you can see. That didn't bother Jesus. Listen to what happened. He reached out his hand and he touched that man. He said, my grace is sufficient for thee.
Sufficient for me. Sufficient for me.
His grace is sufficient and free.
Sufficient for me.
A thief was dying, said, Lord, remember me. Here's Jesus. Today thou shalt be in paradise with me, for my grace is sufficient for thee.
Sufficient for me.
Sufficient for me.
Well, we're glad they stayed with us because we got some great guests on today.
We have some really good people here today.
Yeah, we do. And they're special friends, and we always love to have friends on. You know, that's one thing about the show is not only do we get to enjoy visiting with you every week, a couple times each week.
Absolutely.
But we get to introduce our friends.
We get to introduce our friends and talk with them just a little bit, know a little bit more about them. We know some things, but not all things.
Yeah, we won't tell everything.
No, we won't tell.
Because, you know, he says he doesn't play the piano, but I know he can.
I know.
Okay. Well, let's talk to him, okay?
Let's do it.
Would you join with us in making welcome Pat and Lynell Barker? We're just glad you're here.
Thank you. Good to be here.
I tell you, Pat and Lynell, my goodness. Now, Lynell, we don't get to see you very much, but we see Pat everywhere. How long have you been singing, Pat?
Oh, goodness. Traveling, really, about 15 years. Not a long time. But singing, I started when I was four, you know.
Oh, did you?
Standing on the
you're
stage.
One of those that's just
one of those.
As long as you can stand upright, you
Pat,
probably...
Pat, did you sing bass when you were four?
Not till I was five.
Not did you? Five.
Did you cry in tune?
Your mom probably thinks so.
Yeah.
Well, most of you have seen Pat with various groups.
Yeah.
How did you get to be, and I know that you have sustained, you have jobs that you've kept for a while, but you know, whether it's on TV, whether it's on a cruise, whether it's at a concert, you're utility
everywhere.
Man. Everybody that needs a singer calls you. How did you get there?
I'm cheap.
Oh,
that
you're
is
what?
The, oh, I'm cheap.
No, I don't
cheap.
Believe that.
I don't believe
well,
that,
really, you know, when I left Mark, I'd been with Mark about 4.5 years.
Mark Trammell.
Yeah, and when I left the road about 2 years ago, groups that would need a fill-in for a week or two, they would call me.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And then the Cathedral Family Reunion wanted to keep me on
That's
the tour,
true.
And then Gerald put me on the hymn sing, the second half quartet.
And the Guardians.
The Guardians, yeah. I get to sing with them about 4 or 5 times a year. And so I've sung with Ernie Haas. I've sung with the Michael Ferber Quartet. I've sung
well, listen,
with
we'll
of
get a picture of the roster of Southern Gospel Music, and you'll see his picture put
That's
in there
it.
Somewhere.
That's
well, let's also meet Lynell.
Yes.
You're involved in music, too. We're finding things out about you. We don't see you
no,
on the road,
wonderful.
But tell us about what you do, Lynell.
Well, I teach chorus.
You teach chorus?
I do. I teach in the public schools. I teach middle school chorus.
Oh, great.
Oh, yeah.
And you teach middle school chorus?
Yes.
Is that choral directing? You
it
or
is.
You have a choir?
It is. It's teaching choirs all day long. Sixth, seventh, and eighth graders.
Sixth, seventh. That's the middle school.
Yes, sir.
Well, are you a musician?
I get to sing at church a good deal and enjoy that.
Do you play?
Not well.
She plays about as well as I do.
Oh, I'm sure he's there.
I think both of you play because I know from their own admission that he was a piano minor at the university. Oh, y'all met at the university, didn't
you? We did. We met at Jacksonville State University about 24 years ago. We came in at the same time.
Did you date?
That's awesome.
We did. Yeah, we dated.
You dated at the university?
And then she wised up.
Oh,
I don't know about
that's
that.
Not true, Pat. That's not true.
It took her 20 years to figure out that I'm
oh,
okay.
Me. Well, listen, that's wonderful. That's wonderful.
Well, you've got children, don't you, Pat?
Yeah, three.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
How old are you?
10, 7, and 5.
Are they girls, boys?
Two girls and a boy. The oldest is a boy.
The oldest is a boy.
Yeah,
are you teaching them to sing?
You know what? They have taught themselves.
Really?
They sing all the time.
Oh, really?
Playing something on the radio.
Yeah.
They do. They sing constantly. I'm posting Facebook videos all the time of the kids singing in the car. And,
oh, yeah. I'm going to have to check that out.
Yeah, you need to check that out.
We'll check that out. Well, she's good at checking. What'd you start?
It's very entertaining.
Is it entertaining?
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, children, whatever they do, it seems like it's always entertaining. Their energy makes it entertaining. Well, you know, Pat now sings bass. I'm sure he didn't start out 4 or 5 singing bass. When did your voice change that you realized you could be a bass?
A little later on, honestly. I was about 16, and I had been listening to gospel music for about 3 or 4 years. I didn't catch on until I was about 13.
Oh, really?
But I was listening to Danny Funderburk and Kirk Talley and those guys, the high stuff, because I was singing really high. I was singing
at that time?
Oh, goodness, yes. At 14, 15 into 16.
That's
I was singing Larnell Harris and Steve Green and all these high tracks.
When did you go down?
It took about 3 weeks to go from tenor
Gene
to bass.
Does Gene McDonald have that same kind of story?
I don't know. I know Gene, you know, he's trained in opera singing.
But he was singing tenor for the group out of Kennett, Missouri, singing tenor. And a month later,
I've heard him sing tenor in those. They do these all bass quartets, yeah. And they always put him on the tenor.
Now he's another bass singer. Oh, but he dropped great. About that fast too.
I wouldn't doubt it. It took about 3 or 4 weeks.
Scare you?
Yes. And I had to relearn everything. Like I knew all of Danny's parts, then I had to go and learn George's parts.
That's good. That's
well,
good.
You know, Linnell, today you're not, go ahead.
Yes, I want to ask Linnell, what do you do besides being at school teaching 6, 7, and 8 kids? What do you do when Pat is on the road?
What do you do to enjoy life? Yeah. What do you do to enjoy life?
What do you like?
Well, I enjoy working out. I enjoy exercise.
Oh, yeah?
I do.
Oh,
and I have cool. some wonderful friends. I love just spending time with them and really enjoy being active at church and singing again in our church choir.
Do you do the athletic things? I mean, like running and dumping and all that?
Oh, yeah. Jeez.
No, I don't. That cardio, no.
That, you don't do that fast.
I do. No,
She's
I like classes.
She's much more fit than I am.
No, I like weights. I like
oh, you like weights?
I do. I
now,
like weightlifting.
Jerry does weights, but I don't do the weight thing.
I've walked through the gym a few times.
I love your honesty, Pat. I mean, you just zip right in there and tell it like it is. Well, I'm not a great weightlifter, you know, but I like upper body strength, you know, that part.
That's because he plays golf, though.
And it does help you. I think it helps. And so, and then, of course, because of getting older, the doctor wants me to walk more, that kind of thing.
Do you cook much, Linnell?
He's a much better cook.
A better cook?
I will follow directions, but he is a much better
cook.
See, that's
yeah,
the way I feel
it.
About it.
I enjoy it.
So you're more than
it's very
a
relaxing. Mm-hmm.
What's your specialty?
I don't know if I have a specialty. Mm-hmm. I cook
you
a
like
little bit
all.
Of everything. Now, we
all
love
right.
Mexican food, Italian.
Mm-hmm. Do you go out to those kind of places?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I'm going to throw in another name here, and we'll say you get credit for it.
All right.
But Corey and I... You know,
Corey Pearson.
Yeah, that's right.
Now I'll get credit.
Now you'll get credit. Okay.
That's good.
Yeah, we have a thing. You know, they like to go out to eat, and we like fine dining. So when we travel, and I'm not just throwing out words, but whether we're in Europe or here, we hunt fine dining. You know, we spent mostly in Italy. Mm-hmm. So we would hunt the fine dining places. And so whenever we're at a fine dining place, I'll text Corey, and I'll say, eat your heart out, and I'll show a picture. So, you know,
oh,
and then he does
dining.
It back to me.
Sometimes we'll go to Arby's and do the upsize combo.
Oh,
so it's, you know, we don't mind spending money. I'll tell you that.
Yeah. Oh, man. You know, you're opening up a can of worms.
I can tell you, when you have children, that's just where you go.
That is fine.
You
dining.
Go to
yeah,
Burger
McDonald's
King or McDonald's
that's
or somewhere.
Right.
That's where I take my kids.
There you go.
Sometimes I tell a story, you know, when we're in concert or something, about when we started dating, like our first date. And of course, I'm giving away secrets here on TV, but I'll act like it's the first time I've ever told it, and she acts like it is too. And I say, you know, I wanted to take Jan to a classy place. And so we went out to eat, and she was seated right beside me, and we were holding hands, and she let me order for her, and, you know, it was so nice. And what really impressed me was when I pulled up to the next window, she offered to help pay. Because that sounds like
McDonald's every time.
Are winning, and it wins every time, you know.
That's funny.
Tell us your children's names.
Andy and Breland and Emma. I named them all after the Andy Griffith Show.
You're kidding?
Really?
No,
did
Andy.
You for real?
I did. And then Breland, her middle name is Taylor, uh-huh. So it's B. Taylor.
Oh,
and
my
then
gosh.
Emma was after Emma Watson, who was Aunt Bee's best friend in the first couple of seasons.
Pat Barker. That's
awesome. And we had a dog named Ellie, and so it's...
Okay, we've only got about a minute or two more to talk. Is there anything that we haven't covered that you want to add on here? What is
Goodness.
Your ministry now as far as what do you do?
Really, it is the second half quartet and Cathedral Family Reunion Hymn Sync Tour. That's really the stuff I do mostly. Uh-huh. But I also teach at the Steve Hurst School of Music. Get to do every year, teaching vocal
wonderful.
Performance.
Yes.
And so now what I do mainly is a thing called, you're going to like this, PB&J Productions International. PB&J stands for Pat Barker and Jesus. And so what we do is we do online vocal training. I'll do FaceTime vocal training with folks, do some webcasts, do a lot of different things under that umbrella. But it also includes all the solo concerts and all that kind of stuff. But
that PB&J, is that what it is?
PB&J, yeah.
PB&J, that's peanut butter and jelly.
Well, it can be.
That'll help you remember if you want to.
Did you just think of that?
Well, sure. I thought you were going to say peanut butter and jelly sandwich company.
Well, that's pretty much a staple for us at night.
Oh, I love them.
You know, we have to limit ourselves to, you know, are we going to eat a half one tonight or a whole
that's
one each?
Yes.
Well, it's almost time for you to sing. And before you do, Jen would like for you to have
this book of mine.
Her book, and take this with you when you go. She'll sign it before you leave the studio.
Thank you.
And I know you don't preach as such, but you do ministry.
So you do ministry.
I want to give you two of my books. This is are some of the commencement addresses. You got to promise to read at least the first one.
Absolutely.
That's commencement.
And then I teach church history for the university.
Yes.
So this is the first 500 years of church history, and I wrote this book. So you can read those at your leisure.
Awesome.
All right, get your mic.
Thank you.
Go over there and get in place and be ready.
Yes, you do.
Yeah,
we get
to listen to you sing. Well, we're going to enjoy
one of my very favorite songs that Pat Barker. I know this guy from a long time. Pat Barker, and he's going to sing "Wonderful Time Up There."
All right, talk to music, Mr. Sean.
Everybody's gonna have religion and glory. Everybody's gonna be singing that story. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Glory, hallelujah, brother. There's a reckoning coming in the morning. Better get ready, cause I'm giving you the warning. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Now listen, everybody, cause I'm talking to you. The Lord is the only one to carry you through. You better get ready, and I'm telling you why. Jesus is a-coming from his throne on high. And going down the valley, going one by one, we're gonna be rewarded for the things that we've done. How you gonna feel about the things he'll say on that judgment day? Well, everybody's gonna have religion and glory. Everybody's gonna be singing that story. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Glory, hallelujah, brother. There's a reckoning coming in the morning. Better get ready, cause I'm giving you the warning. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Now you get your holy Bible in the back of the book of Revelation, that's the place you must look. If you understand it, and you can if you try, the Lord is coming from his throne on high. And reading in the Bible about the things he said, he said he's coming back again to raise up the dead. Are you gonna be among the chosen few? Will you make it through? Well, everybody's gonna have religion and glory. Everybody's gonna be singing that story. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time up there. Glory, hallelujah, brother. There's a reckoning coming in the morning. Better get ready, cause I'm giving you the warning. Everybody's gonna have a wonderful time.
this world below, where there's no sickness, toil, nor danger. In that bright world to which I go, I'm going there to see my mother. I'm going there no more to roam. I'm just going over Jordan. I'm just going over. I'm just a poor wayfaring stranger while traveling through this world below, where there's no sickness, toil, nor danger. In that bright world to which I go, just going over. I'm coming
home.
Wow, wasn't that good singing?
I'm telling you.
That little boy can do it.
Well, you know, that's the reason. Probably he's here and there and
everywhere.
I'm telling you. Wonder if, Pat, how about singing with us?
Yeah.
Let's go.
That's
we can get a big old bus and hit the road.
You call home Alabama or Georgia? I know y'all in all.
We've got so much money, we just live in both.
Oh, wow.
I mean, you know,
well,
I mean,
see?
It's Arby's and two houses. That's what we've got. No, honestly, we're still trying to figure all that out, you know, with where we're going to live and all that.
Yeah.
So right now, we're just not sure.
Well, you know what?
We'll figure it
that's
out.
That's the same. Jerry just can't give up his Nashville home, and my babies are here, so I'm not giving up my Georgia home.
I understand completely.
But
well,
I
we'll have you to sing with us sometime.
Yeah. Where the home is where the heart is.
That's right.
And my heart is.
Oh, that was sweet.
That was good, wasn't it?
I tell you what.
Linnell knows how good that is, don't you?
Do y'all have ooh moments?
Oh, yes.
Do you?
Oh, yeah.
Every time I wake up, she goes, ooh.
Oh. Good. You know, I'm going to tell
you,
this is an honest confession. You know, I've been knowing you for years,
sure.
Pat, because you've been around everywhere we are and you are. But I'm learning a different Pat than I've ever known
him. He's funny for one thing.
Yeah. You have subtle humor, don't you?
Well, see, when you're with Mark and Randy Shelnut, you can't talk, so you kind of just have to stand there. So,
okay.
You know, now I get to talk.
Yes.
Mark talks all the time.
But I am learning, and I love the other Pat, but I really love this Pat, I'll tell you.
Well, thank you.
He could hang out with a new Pat. Yeah, he could do that. And yeah. I know I like Linnell, so I could hang. Hey, well, let's have a dinner one
let's
night.
Go. Yeah, we'll go for
I'll
dinner.
I'll send Corey pictures of it.
Yeah, we will. He'll love that.
We're
so glad that you worked it into your schedule, and I know you're busy covering the United States and where all of you may go and the groups. Tell each one that you sing with, we said our hellos.
I absolutely will.
We love them all.
We hope that we'll see more of you.
Yeah.
Maybe back on the show another time.
That would be great.
I think that's music that says we got to get out of here.
That's what that music says.
That
and you know what? We have a motto here, and we like to tell it to each of you. And our motto is, take Christ as your partner and enjoy life.
Do it.
We'll see you at our next taping session. God bless you.